Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and in this video, I want to talk all about migrating your paginated reports from SQL Server reporting services on Power BI Report Server to the Power BI service. Stay tuned. If you're finding this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date on all the videos from both Adam and myself. Okay, what I want to talk about in this video is taking your on-premises paginated reports, or if it's running in a VM in Azure or wherever you're running SSRS or Power BI report server, but I want to talk about taking those paginated reports from there and migrating them up to the cloud. So some of you guys have probably been doing this manually, or you've written your own tools and maybe you didn't know, but there's an RDL migration tool out on GitHub. And that's what I'm gonna talk about in this video today, okay? And so the first place I'm gonna start, wait. You guys know what I like to do? Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So the first place you wanna start is you wanna go over to this Git repo for the RDL migration, and you can download all the code and compile it yourself, or you can go over and click releases, and this will take you to this page right here. And if you scroll down for the current release and you expand assets, and you can download this zip file right here. Once you have that zip file downloaded, go to wherever you downloaded it, copy the contents of that zip file to some location on your machine. So where I copied it, I went to my C drive and I made a folder called all the RDL migration, and I copied all the contents there. So once you do that, there's a guidance document for Power BI that I suggest you go and take a look at. This document walks you through discovering all the content, all the SSRS servers that's out in your environment. Then it says, hey, you can use the MAP tool, the Microsoft Assessment and Planning Toolkit, to do that discovery. And then you would assess your environment and you would check to see if you're using things like mobile reports, or if you're using report models, or things like that, things that are not supported. So you need to go look at all those reports. And then it also says all the way at the top, make sure you're running at least SQL Server reporting services 2012 or later, or Power BI report server. If you're running something earlier than that, then you'll need to do some things to get up to speed if you want to use that tool. Once you know you've did your pre-migration steps and you did a discovery and then assessed your environment, then the next thing you need to do is prepare for the migration. And you would do that by creating a workspace. You need to have a premium per user license or back the workspace by premium. That allows you to migrate to paginated reports, right? Both of those support paginated reports. You should go read the document. There's lots of stuff in the document. I'm sure I missed a few things, but definitely go give it a read, okay? Once you've done that, head back over to that Git repo, because there's four steps that you should understand what's gonna happen when you do this migration. Let me show you. So when you get ready to do this, it's gonna say, okay, if you have any paginated reports that have shared data sources or data sets, it's gonna convert them for you. Then it's gonna check for unsupported data sources. If you're using a data source like ODBC or OLADB that's not supported by paginated reports in the service, it's not gonna use them. It's not gonna convert those for you. Once it does that check, then it's gonna save those converted files locally. Then it's gonna push them up to the workspace that you specify, and then it's gonna provide a summary. It's great, right? It's gonna do all this stuff. You don't need to do anything. You can manually do it. You can write your own code, but if you use this tool, it'll automatically do it for you, okay? There's four options that you have to do this migration. You can migrate your My Reports folder. You can migrate an individual report. If you're running SharePoint integrated mode, you can migrate reports from your SharePoint integrated mode, or if you're in native mode, you could just point to a folder. In this video, I'm gonna point to a specific folder. So I have my Power BI report server, and I have a folder on my Power BI report server labeled paginated reports. It contains 5 reports, and I kind of set up one so you can see what an error is like. I have a shared data source. You'll see how it converts it from a shared data source to an embedded data source. And then I have a report, I think it's this report right here, that has an ODBC connection, which is a non-supported source. It's not supported by paginated reports. I want to migrate all the reports in this folder. And then I went out to Power BI and I created a workspace that's backed by premium per user. Oh, I'm ready to go. And so you can open up a command line. I like to use PowerShell. I opened up PowerShell, the PowerShell ISE, and then I changed the directory that I'm in from the system32 to my RDL migration. I just did a CD in that folder. And then I start typing everything I need. So I have the RDL executable. Then you would specify your report server. And so right here, you would replace this with your report server name if you're not running this locally. And then here, you specify either the folder that contains the the paginated reports, the specific paginated report, your SharePoint integrated URL, or your My Reports. You specify your workspace, and then you need your app ID. To get your app ID, what you would do is you would go to dev.powerbi.com. You would sign in, provide the application name, change the application type to native, and then you would select these three boxes right here: read all workspaces, read and write all data sets, read and write all reports, and you click register. Then it's gonna give your app ID. And so back over in PowerShell, you would paste your app ID right there. So this is the script you want, and it would vary depending on where you're migrating from and where you're migrating to, okay? So then you just click run. When I click run, it's gonna prompt me to authenticate. If this is your first time doing it, you may see an image like this where it's saying, hey, you need to, we're requesting permissions, just click accept. And I put my password in, click sign in, and then down here at the bottom, you're gonna see where it says login successful, starting the conversion. Oh, there was one conflict, and it gives me a really good verbose error here saying, hey, there's an unsupported source of ODBC. So I need to go take a look at that, but it looks like I had some success. So I'm gonna go over to the folder where I copied all those, the contents, and you can see there's my conversion log. There's all the information. There was one that failed to upload. That's okay, I'll go take a look. It's the data source, so I need to change that up. If I go to my output, you can see that it downloaded a copy of all those reports for me and did a conversion. So you can see here where it converted the one. There was one report that had a shared data source, and so it converted it to an embedded data source. So if I open this guy up, what you'll see is that now it has an embedded data source for that particular data source that was there before, the one that was a shared data source. So the important thing to note is it's not doing anything to your reports that to pull it out to your report server or your Power BI report server. It's not modifying them, it's not changing it, it's just getting a copy of them so it can upload them to the service. Just remember that. And so if I head over to the service now, and I'm gonna go ahead and refresh my page, and there's my reports. If I click on one of my reports, cross my fingers, cross my toes, I always say that. I don't know why I always say that. Boom. And like that, there's my report. It just ran, I migrated it. All right, what do you guys think? Yeah, questions, comments? Are you migrating your reports from on-premises to the cloud? Everybody's doing it, so why won't you? All right. But if you do have any questions, if you do have any comments, if you have any thoughts about this, I'd love to know. Let's continue the conversation where? In the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, give me a big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.